And understand, we are the church.
Yes.
These four walls mean nothing.
Yes.
Because when we walk out of here, we got to live a life of God out at work,
yes,
at school,
yes,
in our neighborhoods.
Right.
This building just sitting here. Right. This just houses where you come. So when you talk about the church, it's talking about individuals.
Yes.
It's, all you do is come to fellowship. To get renewed.
Yes.
You know, you drive your car so long, you got to put some more gas in it sometime. In a Christian walk, you got to come and be re-energized.
Right. Right.
You got to come and be encouraged. You got to come and be challenged. And that's what the job of the church is.
Yes.
That's what the job of the church is. They had real church back then, where your inner soul got blessed in the service of the Lord. Where you came to church and you left and feel like you've been to church.
Yeah.
Like God moved. Like God ministered to you. Like God strengthened you. Like God encouraged you. That's the kind of church they had back then. Mm. The Bible tells us that prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for Peter. Mm-hmm. The church prayed.
Yeah.
Churches ain't even praying today.
Yeah.
They had a prayer chain going for Peter. The saints. When he was put in prison. And the sixth verse tells us when Herod would have brought him forth the same night, Peter was sleeping. When Herod would have brought Jesus forth to kill him that next day, Peter was sleeping. Peter was at rest. Between two soldiers, the Herod, the king, had two soldiers bound him with two chains. They had a chain from his hands and his feet. And a keeper before the door.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping the prison to make sure Peter didn't get away.
Right.
The devil thought he had Peter bound.
Yep.
Right.
Ready to kill him.
Right.
Devil got a death warrant out on all of us, I keep telling you.
Yeah.
But bound with two chains and the keeper before the door kept the prison. But God heard the prayers of the church. For Peter. God heard the prayers of the body of Christ. God heard the prayers of the righteous. Have mercy, Lord. You know, sometime when you sleep at night, when you're in tune with God, your spirit is crying out to God. Because you know, a spirit don't sleep. When you sleep, when your body rests and your spirit is still woken alive and alert to what's going on around you, the spirit being.
Yes.
You know that.
Yes.
And you know God is a spirit.
Yes.
So when your spirit connect with God's spirit, connect with the spirit word, what Jesus meant when he told Nicodemus, you must be born again.
Yes.
Got to be born of the spirit. Yes. You got to have a fusion of the spirit dwelling in you.
Yes.
Seventh verse said, and behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him.
Yes.
The angel. I keep telling you, if you believe in God, you got to believe in the spirit realm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to believe in angels. When Jesus was in the Garden of Gethsemane, he said, think not that I can't pray to my Father now. And he'll send me 12 legions of angels.
Right.
When Elijah and Elijah.
Right.
When the army was against him.
Yeah.
He kept telling them, they that be for us is more than they that against us.
Yes, Lord.
Elijah said, open his eyes that he may see me. In the trees, there was angels wrapped all in the trees, waiting to defend Elijah and Elijah. The spirit world. The spirit world. When Jesus cast out demons in the natural, the demons spoke to Jesus in the spirit and said, Jesus, we know who thou art.
Yeah.
Have thou come to torment us before our time?
Yeah.
The people didn't see it. They did not have an eye. But Jesus saw it. Angels are real. They're ministering spirits. They're ministering spirits. When Mary was to give birth to Jesus, an angel came down to Mary and said, thou shalt be give birth to a child. Elizabeth, Gabriel, came down, a messenger angel from God.